Hey y'all, it's Kevin. Out of the plethora of schools you applied and got admitted to, you're considering coming to Cal Poly Pomona. Well, if you choose to come here, it hopefully won't be a decision that you'll regret. And to the ones that have already decided, welcome. The first step, or the first thing you should do once you've decided to attend Cal Poly, is to celebrate. You've struggled through four grueling and maybe also fun years of high school, and now you can attend one of the best institutions on the West Coast. Be proud of your accomplishments. However, make sure that you apply for the FASFA, or the Federal Application for Federal Student Aid. Even if you think you might not qualify for aid, it's beneficial to use as a resource to delay payment of certain fees or prove your income level without filing more paperwork. The FASFA uses tax information from 2 years ago to calculate how much aid you should get. If that amount is less than what you've hoped, you can apply for a request for income review with Cal Poly based on your current income info, for them to help make a better informed decision regarding your financial aid. The deadline for the FASFA is March 2nd. Everything that I mentioned here is gonna be in the description down below. The second step is to apply for housing. There's a requirement that all freshmen live on campus. However, if you live in a close radius within 20 miles or present extraordinary circumstances, you could file for an exemption. It's best to apply as early as possible because spots do fill up quickly and there usually is a waiting list. Once you apply, you have to pay a housing deposit for $450. I know that's a lot, but there's a deferment for the payment of the deposit until your first rent is due. The secret that they won't tell you is that there's usually a deferment for everything. You just have to find out. This video's in the cards above and the description down below in helping you choose a dorm. The third step is to pay your ECD, or Enrollment Confirmation Deposit, by May 1st. It's like SRR in the UCs. There's a deferment for this as well. Next is to register for orientation. At orientation, you find out about the school, learn about the resources that are offered to you, and enroll in classes. I have a video on my experiences there as well. It's important to register for the earliest date possible because that allows you to enroll in your classes sooner as they tend to fill up quickly and have a waitlist. Another important time of orientation is the tour. Many people brush it off, but if you pay attention, it will help you learn to navigate campus on your first day. I would also walk the campus again before leaving after orientation to help get accustomed to where everything is. If you pay over $7,000 a year in tuition, it's best to know where your money is going to and how to get that back and the resources that are offered. There's also a cost for orientation, but that can be deferred as well. The fifth step is to register for the ALEKS PPL, or the Calculus Placement Test. It used to be called the MDPT or the MPDT. If you're an engineering science, food science, or nutritional major, it's imperative to take it. Some majors require you to take a calculus class as soon as you enter. Without taking the test, you'll be required to take lower level math courses like algebra or pre-calculus before you can take calculus. However, if you can be exempt from taking a test if you received a 3 or higher on the AP Calc exam, taking college algebra or trigonometry at another college, or owned 4 or higher on the IB Math HL. The test is so important that the school requires you to take 2 practice assessments before your test date. I would also study a bit more with the guided study guides to be successful. The next step is to submit your final high school transcripts and AB, IB, or CLEP scores by June 30th. And lastly, at least 2 weeks before your orientation, complete several assignments. These include the English Directive Self-Placement Survey, which helps you determine which English class you should enroll in, the online orientation course, the alcohol echeck-up, and upload your ID photo to Cloud Card for your Bronco ID or Cal Poly ID. Most of these are located in Blackboard under Organizations. Take a look at your major's website and review the curriculum sheets and roadmaps. These can help you determine what classes you should take in order to graduate on time. In the meantime, while you wait for orientation, you might get a couple of emails. One of them might be for Early Start or Summer Bridge. These are programs that allow you to attend classes on campus for a few weeks over the summer. They not only allow you to take a peek behind the curtain at the Cal Poly learning experience, but also to bond with other students and give you a taste of campus life. Even though these do have fees, I would highly encourage you to attend, as those can be deferred or waived as well. You might also get an email to enroll in the California Promise Pledge or the 4-year pledge. This allows you to receive priority registration when enrolling in classes. Because classes are impacted, being a part of this program is essential to graduating in a timely manner. And I believe that's it, y'all. If you guys have any more further questions, hopefully they'll be answered in the links down below. Or you can just comment on this video and ask us as well. We'll try and get back to you as soon as possible.